Hello, I'm Daniela. In today's slow stitching video, I'm going to show how I'm inspired by a 1970s era camera to make a piece for my slow stitching. Now I'm taking you back to a time when cameras were held with two hands, you looked through a little viewfinder, and you had to snap a photo and it made a very audible click that you heard, and you really had to push with your finger. My sisters used to have these cameras. They were little rectangular boxes. They held 12 to 24 pictures at a time. You had to wait until the film was developed to see what your photo looked like. Now, those cameras were durable. They certainly didn't do anything a cell phone would do, and they barely took pictures at that. But it was a time that was very enjoyable, and particularly when you had to pose for the picture. Nowadays, everyone has cameras on their phones, and you can always assume you're being filmed. But at that time, you had to stop for the picture and make sure it was being taken properly. So that's the image that I'm using, that I'm inspired by for my slow stitching pieces. There's lots of geometric shapes, from the big lens in the front to the buttons that you push down, and you can add any other little embellishments that you'd like. I like to use bold and fun colors on these cameras just because they're so simple and almost childlike. And here's how I do it. So here's a slow stitch old type vintage camera, and it's very rustic. It's got just basic shapes. I created just some painted versions here in my sketchbook, just really emphasizing the lens, the shape, and just some other fun colors. I tend to like bright colors, so that's why I stuck with them. So these are my guides. But to do it on stitching is a whole different matter, and it's kind of a fun effect. Now, you can use it in your slow stitching as well. You can make a book page, or you can just play with the different shapes of that vintage camera. And I like the way that looks. And here's one that will do something like this today. They all use the simple shape for the lens, and you could put that in the center, you can off-center it, depending on the camera that you're trying to go for. You can round the edges to your camera or make them square. And then you can add lots of different elements to it. They're all very whimsical and fun, and I happen to really like these bright colors with it. The lens is surrounded by a bright color, but you could obviously play around with that and make it the inverse. So the bright color is the lens, and then it's just framed with a color. Then there are buttons on top of the camera, maybe a little flash, and then maybe some buttons on the side of the lens. You can really go to town with it. So let's get started. So I'll just start with a little piece of base. This is just muslin, and this is what I'm going to attach my camera to. Now you can stitch your camera just on your denim if you want. I just like to use it on this muslin. I can always cut it away from the background, or I can just use this in my slow stitching as well. I have some denim that I use for the camera body itself, and there are different colors of denim. You just choose the one you want. I have some dark color that I can use for the lens. You can always go with the traditional black. You can make it a solid color. I tend to like these vibrant colors, and I think I'm going to use this turquoise. I think it's quite intriguing. And then for the buttons and the other gadgets, I have some other colors. Again, they're nice and bright, and they coordinate with that turquoise. So I think I'll use that. And then I have just a little piece of muslin here. I might need a bigger piece to frame my lens. So I'll play around with that as well. So let's get started cutting out our shapes. You can make these any size you want. I like just a little pocket size camera, like those old school ones. I'll start out with my camera body here, and I think I'll use this light blue. And then I just cut this to shape, basically to size. I always start with a rectangle. And then I can decide if I want to round the edges or if I want to make it narrow or chunky. It's really up to you. So there I have my camera body, and I can just put it right on my background here, my little muslin piece, because I know that's where I'm going to stitch it down. I'm going to actually just trim it down a little further. And that's more the size that I want. And you can make this as perfectly sized as you want. This works for me. Now I want to take and work on my lens. So I want the lens to be approximately this big. I'm going to take my lens fabric and just trace around the size that I want for that. This is just the cap to a candle. And I also know that I want the lens to have a little border. So I'm going to cut both my lens and my border fabric at the same time. So I'll just make that circle. They'll be the same size with this initial cut. And then from here, I just have to take my lens and I just fold it just in a few places here, maybe three times. And I'll just trim it down a little, just cutting around the edge. Now it won't make a perfect circle, and I can always just trim it up again, just where it needs to be cut. And then I have my lens with a little border, and I like the way that looks. I can always trim it down further, but I'm pretty happy with that. So my camera is starting to come along. Now I want to decide what kind of buttons I want, or if I want a border up top. And I like the way this color looks with it. So I'll just cut a little strip here. And again, this is all about the placement and the design of this camera. So that worked pretty well. And now I want my little buttons. I'll make two buttons here with this fabric, this beautiful orange fabric. I think that looks really interesting. So I like to make one button kind of had a rounded edge. So I'll just trim that down and just round the edge. See how that looks, poking out from underneath the camera. And that looks pretty good. That looks pretty good. Now I want a little button on this side as well. So I'll just trim that down. I think I'll just make a little angular edge here and tuck this underneath. So there I have my little camera designed. And now I get to start stitching it. I'm going to take a pin and pin these things in place. These little fabric patches, because I'm happy with the way they look and where they're placed. And then I'll take one more just for this lens. And now I want to take my thread and start stitching it down. So I'm going to take my thread that matches my lens, and I'm just going to make a split stitch all the way around. So I'll just come up on one side here, make a little stitch around the edge, and I'm leaving maybe an eighth of an inch to a quarter of an inch. Come up through that stitch, and it might take a few times. And then just make a stitch the same distance as that first one. And then continue all the way around doing that. And this makes a really nice curve. Just have to make sure I come through that stitch and continue all the way around. Now I like this as a border. Because I'm using the six strands of embroidery floss, it becomes a design element and it adds a little bit of texture as well. And I'm really pleased with that. It's one of my favorite colors to use, so I really don't think I can go wrong. The beauty of the split stitch is that when you stitch through it, you anchor it into place. So if your stitch wobbles just a little, you have a little way to kind of rework it by stitching it down. So there I've stitched around my lens. I can stitch additional pieces if I want, but I'm pretty happy with that. So now I want to come in here with some of this coral thread and stitch around my buttons to hold them in place. So again, you can choose to make whatever stitch you want. I'm just going to do a straight stitch. And again, I go around the perimeter of each of these buttons. Now, because it's that thick embroidery floss, it is a design element. And I'm really trying just to make that border right around this button. You can use a contrasting thread if you'd like. I happen to like the way that that same tone and that same color matches up. My thread is a little lighter than my fabric, but it coordinates quite nicely. So I'll stitch this button down, not my thread on the back, stitch the other one down, and then we'll come back and take a look at what's our next step. So now I've stitched my little buttons down, and now I want to stitch this just decorative border around. I can just take my yellow thread and make my stitches. And again, I think I'm just going to do the straight stitch here. Now when I get to the center, I can decide if I want to make a little viewfinder, and if I want to use stitches to do that, or fabric, or I can even use paint. It's really up to you and how much detail you want to make in your little vintage camera. Now when I say vintage, I don't mean vintage as the 1930s with the giant bulb that flashes. I'm talking vintage as in like the 1970s and 80s. So now that I've added that edge up top, I want to just add a little viewfinder here. So I'll take some dark thread and maybe put the viewfinder right here. While I have some yellow on my needle though, I think I'm going to make just some trim along the bottom here. And I'll just make my line with my heat removable marker, just so I have a guide to make a straight line. And I'll just add some decorative stitching, just because I can. And it's a textile piece, so the decorative stitching would be very appropriate. I'm going to just use some straight stitches. I'll try and keep them all approximately the same length. And then I'll just make a band at the bottom of the camera. Because this is an artistic endeavor though, you don't have to make it straight, you don't have to make it reminiscent of an old camera, you can just add stitches however you'd like. And that's what makes these pieces unique, is everybody has just a different idea of how they want to do that and incorporate stitching into their piece. So we take an idea of this camera, we use the angles, we play with the color, we take advantage of some beautiful fabric, and then we add stitches, and it's starting to come alive. Something very unusual in our work. So I'll knot the back here. So now to make the viewfinder, I have my little area up top here, and I'm just going to make the satin stitch. So I'm just going to create that rectangle shape, the area where you'd peek through to take your photo, long before the digital cameras had the screens on the back. So I'll just make a series of straight up and down stitches to indicate that. Now I'm spacing them out originally, and then I'm just going to go back in and fill them as I go. And I'll speed this along, and you can start to see how it starts to fill in with each additional stitch. So now I just want to take some thread and tack down the border of my camera body. So I'll start at the bottom, and this is just some off-white pearl thread, and I'm just going to make the straight stitch going the length up and down the top of this camera. When I get to the top, I'll stitch the length of the camera going right across that denim edge. So now I'm at the bottom of the camera, and I think I want to stitch right along the base here. I think that'll make the yellow trim there really stand out as trim and not just as the border of the camera. So I'll just make a few stitches along the base here. So before I finish up any final details, I'll just take a hot iron and remove any of those markers that remain that I use to help me draw my sketch. It's time to decide if I want any other elements. I think I want to have a little tab here, and I'll create it in that coral. And I can do it on either side of the camera, maybe on this side. So I'll just make a little stitch. And then I'll stitch over it with just a little satin stitch. You can do as many as you'd like. You can write the camera's name. Anything that goes, really, just to make it a little more personal. And I think all the little details add up and look quite nice when it's done. The last thing I want to do, though, is stitch around that border. And I'll just use some of that little off-white pearls to do that. And so there I have my finished stitched camera. It's kind of a fun little design element that I can use in my work. So I hope you found this process of creating these vintage cameras using textiles and fabric to be really enjoyable. The cameras themselves were simple shapes and very geometric, and that's what we were trying to capture with our stitching. We also added a few little elements of stitching and a few little fun notes, maybe a French knot here or some satin stitching there to give it additional texture. Thanks for joining me today. If you found this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up and be sure to subscribe.